Abdominal hernia. Abdominal hernia is protrusion of an abdominal viscus or part of a viscus through a defect. There is an important oral and clinical question. What are the types of abdominal hernia? Abdominal hernias are classified according to the appearance on the surface of the abdomen. If the hernia appear on the surface of the abdominal wall, it is called external abdominal hernia. And external abdominal hernia is the commonest type of hernia. Less commonly, the hernia may occur inside the abdomen and doesn't appear on the surface of the anterior abdominal wall. And in this case, the hernia is called internal abdominal hernia. First of all, what are the types of internal abdominal hernia? The commonest and the typical internal abdominal hernia is diaphragmatic hernia. Diaphragmatic hernia may be congenital, through a congenital defect like that. This is the diaphragm, and there may be a congenital defect on the left side or in the right side or anteriorly. And through this congenital defect, the abdominal viscus, like in small intestine, or like part of large intestine, or in this case, part of spleen, herniate from the abdomen to the thorax. And this is called congenital abdominal hernia, which will be discussed in detail in pediatric surgery later on. Much more common, diaphragmatic hernia may be acquired through this defect. This is the abdominal part of the esophagus. The thoracic part of the esophagus passes to the abdomen, and this is the abdominal part of the esophagus, and this opening is the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm. Through the esophageal hiatus of the diaphragm, this may occur. This is the stomach, and this is the diaphragm, and this is the esophageal hiatus in the diaphragm. Through the esophageal hiatus, part of the stomach may herniate into the lower part of the thorax, and this is called hiatus hernia, which is much, much more common than congenital diaphragmatic hernia. Internal abdominal hernia may occur through the foramen of Winslow. What is the foramen of Winslow? This is the famous cut section in the peritoneal cavity. This transverse section occurs at the level of spleen, stomach, and this fold of peritoneum, which is called the lesser omentum. And this is a free border of the lesser omentum, which is containing most posteriorly portal vein and the anteriorly bile duct and hepatic artery. Posterior to the free border of the lesser omentum, there is a foramen called the foramen of Winslow or epibloic foramen, or foramen to the lesser sac. This foramen lies between the portal vein, which is the most posterior structure in the free border of the lesser omentum, and this large vein on the posterior abdominal wall, which is the inferior vena cava. This cut section also passing through the peritoneal cavity, which is the bluish color. This blue color is the peritoneal cavity. The peritoneal cavity is divided into a large part in front of the stomach and the front of the lesser omentum. This large part of peritoneal cavity is called greater sac. Greater because it is the larger part of the peritoneal cavity. While posterior to the stomach and the lesser omentum, posterior to the stomach and the lesser omentum, there is a small part of peritoneal cavity. Because this is a small part of peritoneal cavity, this part is called lesser omentum. The greater omentum is complete, the greater sac is completely separated from the lesser sac, except by this opening. This is the site of connection, the only site of connection between greater sac and the lesser sac, which is the foramen of Wien's law. Therefore, it is called also foramen to the lesser sac. This is a longitudinal section at the level of the liver, lesser omentum, stomach, and all this pinkish color is the large part of the peritoneal cavity, which is the greater sac. While this pale blue color is the smaller part of the peritoneal cavity, which is the lesser sac. And this is the only connection between the greater sac and the lesser sac, which is the foramen of Wien's law. The small intestine and the large intestine lies in, this is the small intestine, and the mesentery of small intestine lies in the greater sac. This is part of transverse colon, lies in the greater sac. If loops of small intestine or large intestine pass through the foramen of Wien's law to the lesser sac, this is an internal hernia through the foramen of Wien's law. This is the actual appearance of, this is the stomach, and this is the lesser omentum, and behind the free border of the lesser omentum is the foramen of Wien's law, and through the foramen of Wien's law pass part of small intestine and the part of colon, which is an internal hernia through the foramen of Wien's law. The third type of internal hernia is paraduodenal hernia. This is the stomach, and this is the duodenum. And around the fourth part of the duodenum and the third part of the duodenum, there are pouches or recesses called paraduodenal recesses, like that. This is the third part of the duodenum, and this is the ascending part, fourth part of the duodenum. And these pouches are called paraduodenal recesses. If loops of small intestine pass in these pouches through the paraduodenal recesses, this type of hernia is internal hernia and called paraduodenal hernia, which occur in the paraduodenal recesses. Similarly, the same thing may occur around the cecum. This is the cecum and surrounded also by pouches or recesses called the paracecal recesses. If part of small intestine pass in this recesses or pouches, this is an internal hernia called paracecal hernia. Then the same thing may occur in the sigmoid mesocolon. This is the sigmoid colon. And this fold of peritoneum is called sigmoid mesocolon. And here there is a recesses. There is one recess called the intersigmoid recess. If part of small intestine or lobe of small intestine pass in this recess, this hernia is an internal hernia called intersigmoid hernia. Very rarely, this is the small intestine held by the hand of a surgeon, and this fold is called the mesentery of small intestine. Here, there is a defect appear in the mesentery of small intestine, and this cirrhosis defect pass part of small intestine and its mesentery. This internal hernia, and this hernia which occurs through a defect in the mesentery of small intestine is called transmesenteric hernia. The last type of internal hernia is, this is the stomach, and a part of stomach is removed. After removal of a part of stomach, gastrojejunostomy, anastomosis is done between the stomach and the jejunum, called the gastrojejunostomy, ostomy mean anastomosis, opening between the stomach and the jejunum. This operation is removal of part of the stomach followed by gastrojejunostomy. Where is the internal hernia? After this anastomosis, loops of a small intestine with this arrow pass behind the anastomosis, and this is called retroanastomotic hernia. All these types are rare types, and all these types are internal hernia. The commonest types of hernia, not internal. The commonest types of hernias are external hernias, which appear on the surface of the abdominal wall. The external hernia are classified into anterior hernia, posterior hernia, perineal hernia, and the incisional hernia. Abdominal hernia, which appear on the anterior abdominal wall, is called anterior hernia. The anterior hernia may be in the middle line, called ventral hernia. Anterior hernia in the middle line include, may occur in the umbilicus, called umbilical hernia, or just near the umbilicus, called the para-umbilical hernia, or in the epigastric region, called the epigastric hernia. These are three hernia are ventral, means in the middle line. The anterior hernia may be on the lateral aspect, on the lateral border of rectus abdominis. If hernia appear on the lateral border of rectus abdominis, this lateral hernia is called the Spechelian hernia. The most famous hernia are groin hernia. This is an anterior hernia, appear in the groin. Anatomically, groin means the area above and below the inguinal ligament. Anterior hernia, if occur in the groin, may occur above the inguinal ligament. And this is the famous hernia and the commonest hernia, which is called inguinal hernia. And the inguinal hernia may be direct, which is rare, and the commonest hernia is indirect inguinal hernia. If the hernia appear below the groin, if hernia appear below the groin, usually it appear in the femoral triangle. If appear in the femoral triangle, it is called femoral hernia. Very rarely, groin hernia may occur below the inguinal ligament through the obturator canal in the medial group of the muscles of the thigh. And this rare hernia is called obturator hernia. This is anatomically the hip bone, and we sure all know that this is the obturator foramen, which is closed by obturator membrane, leaving a small passage called the obturator canal for passage of obturator nerve and vessels. If loops of intestine pass through this obturator canal, it is called obturator hernia, and it is a very rare hernia. Therefore, groin hernia, which is anterior hernia, may occur above the inguinal ligament, which is inguinal hernia, direct and in the indirect, or it may be below the inguinal ligament, which is usually femoral hernia, or rarely obturator hernia. These are the anterior hernia, ventral in the middle line 3 hernias, umbilical, paraumbilical, epigastric, or anterior hernia may be lateral, spigelian hernia at the lateral edge of rectus abdominis, or anterior hernia may be groin hernia above the inguinal ligament or below the inguinal ligament. The hernia may be posterior hernia. Posterior hernia appear on the posterior aspect. The hernia may be superior lumbar hernia or inferior lumbar hernia in the lumbar region. In the lumbar region may be superior or inferior lumbar hernia or descend slightly downward. In the hip bone, there are two foramina, greater sciatic foramen, where loops of intestine rarely pass through this foramen, and in this case, it is called sciatic hernia. There is a small foramen below the greater large. There is a smaller foramen below the greater sciatic foramen called lesser sciatic foramen because it is small. The lesser sciatic foramen loops of intestine may pass through the lesser sciatic foramen, and this hernia is called gluteal hernia, which appear on the posterior aspect. Sciatic hernia and the gluteal hernia appear here in the gluteal region. Therefore, posterior hernia may be lumbar hernia, superior or inferior lumbar hernia. And this is the inferior lumbar hernia just above the iliac crest. And gluteal or sciatic hernia. These are the famous type of external hernia. Very rarely, hernia may pass through this region. What is this region? This region is the perineum, which is the outlet of the pelvis. And through the outlet of the pelvis, very rarely pass perineal hernia. Anterior hernia occur in the anterior abdominal wall. Posterior hernia occur in the posterior abdominal wall or in the gluteal region. Perineal hernia occur in the perineum. There is one type of hernia which may occur anteriorly, posteriorly, or in the perineum, which is the hernia which occur at any site, incisional hernia. If there is incision in the anterior abdominal wall, hernia occur anteriorly. If there is incision in the posterior abdominal wall, hernia may be posterior. If incision in the perineum, incisional hernia may occur in the perineum. Therefore, incisional hernia may occur at any site according to the incision of the operation, because the incision of any operation leave a weak area in the abdominal wall. Through this weak area, incisional hernia may occur at any site according to the site of the incision. These are the types of hernia, internal and external hernias.